Ladies and gentlemen, Carly Russell has been arrested and she's got charged with two misdemeanors. So, wow. Carly Russell charged in connection with kidnapping hoax. Well, I knew they were going to make an example out of her, but she's far from the only one that have falsified things to the police. So Carly Russell, an Alabama nursing student who claimed she was kidnapped for 49 hours in a stunt she later confessed to be a lie. She was charged with two misdemeanors in connection with the hoax, police announced Friday. The arrest warrant was issued earlier today. Hoover Police Chief Nicholas C. Derzis. This is what he said during a news conference. So she surrendered to authorities accompanied by her attorney at the Hoover City Jail to face two misdemeanor charges. Also reporting to law enforcement authorities and falsely reporting an incident, he said. So, ladies and gentlemen, I heard about the amount of time that she would have to serve. It's actually a year. And it depends on whether she had any priors. It may not even be a year. But that's the maximum they can give her. So, the charges carry a bond of $1,000 each. And she could spend up to a year in jail and a $6,000 fine if she's convicted, according to the police chief.
Earlier today, Hoover police detectives obtained warrants for the arrest of Carly Russell through the Hoover Municipal Court for her actions related to faking her kidnapping and subsequently making false statements to detectives as they investigated this case. Her decisions that night created panic and alarm for the citizens of our city and even across the nation as the concern grew that a kidnapper was on the loose using a small child as bait. Numerous law enforcement agencies, both local and federal, began working tirelessly not only to bring Carly home to her family, but locate a kidnapper that we know now never existed. Many private citizens volunteered their time and energy into looking for a potential kidnapping victim that we know now was never in any danger. This story opened wounds for families whose loved ones really were victims of kidnappings, some of which even helped organize searches in hopes they could find Carly's alive so that her family would not experience the pain and suffering that they felt when their loved ones never returned home. As we know, actions can have consequences, and that's why we're here today. This afternoon, Carly Russell, with the assistance of her attorney, turned herself into the Hoover City Jail, where she was arrested for the following charges: false reporting to law enforcement authorities, Class A misdemeanor, $1,000 bond; falsely reporting an incident, a Class A misdemeanor with a $1,000 bond. Each of these charges carry up to a year in jail and potential fine of $6,000 upon conviction. Ms. Russell was released from jail after posting bond. We initially presented this case to District Attorney Lanice Washington, who agreed to handle prosecution through district court. After consulting with the Circuit Court of Jefferson County Bessemer Division, the case was referred back to municipal court for charging because the only applicable charges were misdemeanors. Judging from the amount of phone calls and emails that we've received from people all over the country, I know many are shocked and appalled that Ms. Russell is only being charged with two misdemeanors, despite all the panic and disruption her actions caused. Let me assure you, I too share the same frustration, but existing laws only allow the charges that were filed to be filed. I can tell you that I will be contacting our state legislatures on behalf of law enforcement in Montgomery and asking them to look at this law applied to these facts and urge them to add an enhancement to current legislation when somebody falsely reports kidnapping or another violent crime. Because of the attention this case has garnered, we've requested Attorney General Steve Marshall's office adopt this case, and they've agreed to do so. The Hoover Police Department wants to thank everyone that assisted us from the beginning and continues to assist us in this case.
Okay, so the video you just saw was the Hoover PD police chief, And this is the statement that he gave, shortly after she was arrested. So I have another video that I want you to see from NBC News.
We're following breaking news this hour on a story we've been talking about for the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, the Alabama woman who admitted to lying about being kidnapped is now facing criminal charges. The announcement made by police in Alabama just moments ago. NBC News correspondent Priscilla Thompson joins us now, as well as NBC News legal analyst Danny Savalos joining us on set once again. Priscilla, let's start with you. All of this just broke minutes ago. Tell us, what do we know right now?
Yeah, so police announced that they did arrest Carly Russell and process her within the last hour, and she has since been released. But she is now charged with two misdemeanors, false reporting to law enforcement and falsely reporting an incident. And what the police chief said just minutes ago was that she created panic and alarm throughout the community as people were searching for her for days after she had reported this child that she had seen walking alone on the interstate and then went missing shortly thereafter. And of course, earlier this week, she came out and said that that was all a lie that she had done on her own, that she had no help with that. And so now police are charging her for that. They're saying that there were countless resources and time that went into looking for her, and there are consequences for that. And so these two misdemeanors carry up to a year in jail and potentially $6,000 in fines. We know that she does have a lawyer, so it will remain to be seen how exactly all of this will play out in court or whether she will try to plead to something. We don't yet know. But police here really trying to send a message and saying that this is what they're able to charge her with, but they are still looking at the possibility of any additional charges that could come out of all of this. Ellison's and Clay.
Danny, let me bring you in here, because Carly Russell, as Priscilla laid out, has been charged with two misdemeanors. She laid out some of the consequences of that. How typical, have we seen anything like this before? How serious are these charges?
Sure. Prosecutors will charge people for making false reports. And in Alabama, these are Class A misdemeanors, which means that, as is the same mostly throughout the states, a misdemeanor will have a maximum penalty of a year. That's what this is in Alabama. That's not always the rule, but generally speaking, misdemeanors up to a year, anything beyond that is going to be felony land. So what's good for her is that she's in misdemeanor land. What's bad for her is that she's on the highest end of misdemeanor land, Class A. And of course, with these kinds of aggravating factors that we just heard, the amount of resources that were put into this hunt, in this rescue operation, whatever you want to characterize it, those are all things that a judge may look at. And she might end up with some jail time if convicted. Not the full year. It'll depend on her prior record. But there may be some incarceration. It'll be totally up to the judge, as it often is in misdemeanor cases.
Good to have some clarity now, but still a hard case across the board, all around. Priscilla Thompson, Danny Savalos, thank you both so much.
Okay, so you heard the NBC video. Now, my question is, will this apply to Karen, who is always falsifying police phone calls in this country? So if you're going to change the law because of this one incident, but you're not even talking about the other incidents that they're calling in violence and they're being threatened. And I mean, what about that? You know, it's always convenient when they try to find somebody that looked like us to charge. Now, what she did was wrong. She should not have done it, you know, but Karen should not be out here doing these things either, falsifying and lying to the police. So y'all, all I'm saying is, if you're going to apply it to one, you need to apply it to all. That's all I'm saying. But y'all, please tell me what you think about this video. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace, family.